All right, everyone, thank you so much. We have our first question coming from Tanji. Tanji asks, my green card EAD is approved. Can I keep both H-1B and EAD? I'm not planning to go outside the United States. So let's break down what this question is and what it means. This person, Tanji, apparently has H-1B visa. This is a specialized knowledge employee worker. Someone comes to the United States for some job that requires a bachelor's or above, and they're working here. In the meantime, they're able to file for a green card. Probably the same employer filed for their green card. When you file for the actual green card with Form I-485, Adjustment of Status, you can also apply for work permit and travel permission. So Tanji applied, they got the H-1B, the existing visa, and now they have this work permit. So the H-1B, you can only work at the jobs that you are exactly permitted to work at. The EAD is more general, you can work at other places, but you don't necessarily wanna do that because it might mess up your H-1B or status or future. So you'd wanna talk with the immigration attorney private about that. But what's interesting is they have both. So they're asking, which one do I keep? Well, you don't have to do anything right now. You have your H-1B, you're working. Now, if you leave the United States, along with that work permit that you got based on adjustment of status, EAD, there's a thing called advanced parole you probably got. If you leave and re-enter, but re-enter with the advanced parole, you'll start working with the EAD. But you don't really wanna do that in your case because you have an H-1B visa. An H-1B visa, and this is getting complicated, might be losing people here, but the H-1B visa is called a dual intent visa where you could leave while an adjustment of status I-485 case is pending, and the case still remains valid. It doesn't get disappeared, whereas if you had other types of visas, it would. So no matter, I'd have to talk with you individually, see the whole situation, but most likely you always just want to maintain the H-1B, travel back and forth with that. But there may be situations, for example, 6 months have gone since you filed for I-485, and you want to change employers, there's a thing called portability. If that happens, I'd still want you to do an H-1B transfer, as they put it, it's not really a transfer, or just use your EAD, but make sure to update the US government about the new job, and there's a lot of stuff you have to do for that. This question could go really complicated if I want to go into it, but the basics of it is if you just continue with your work, nothing crazy is gonna happen, you're not traveling, just keep working at H-1B, you don't have to worry about any of this stuff. I hope you enjoyed this educational video. Also, you'll find our social media site has a lot more videos, images, and information about the US immigration process. Please check those out on the various social media websites.